Hi, everyone. Welcome to Urban Wealth Management, Smart Women, Savvy Money 2010 webinar series. For those of you who have joined us in the past, you know how it goes, and for new folks, this is 30 minutes on the clock, 20 minutes to reach you and share some ideas with you, and 10 minutes to talk. Smart Women Savvy Money is a platform offered through our firm, Urban Wealth Management, designed to provide women with the tools and the resources they need to create the life they desire and deserve. Our calls are held on the second Thursday of every month from 1 to 1:30 Pacific time. We have a great lineup of webinars, and I'll show you what we have lined up in the near future. And, of course, we're looking for ideas. We're putting together our list for 2018. So if anyone has any ideas, you know how to find us, just reach out and send us a note, and we'd be more than happy to consider some of your ideas. Before we get started today, let's talk about some housekeeping items. First, our call is being recorded, and secondly, it will be available for replay for all who are registered. And of course, and if you have any comments or questions, please use your chat box. Depending on the platform you're on, it could be on the side of your screen or the middle or the top. So first of all, let's look at what we're doing. Of course, we're talking about investing in women today, and I'll get to that shortly. If you've been following us online or on our email, you'll know that there is a conference coming up in Los Angeles this Saturday, Mount St. Mary's University's 2017 Women's Leadership Conference. It's an all-day event. It's going to have fabulous speakers. We had a chance to partner with them. I'm facilitating a panel discussing Beyond the Boys Club. We're really excited about that. They just released a few more tickets, so if you're interested, please sign up. It's all day. It's at their Brentwood campus, and there is a promo code, so please reach out and let me know if you're interested in doing that. We are going to, secondly, starting on October 9th, we're going to host a six-part webinar, Beyond the Piggy Bank, The Essentials of Investing. It'll be a six-part series where we'll be discussing some of the essentials of investing, helping you get set up and what are some priorities regarding your financial life, everything from savings to planning to investment. So we're looking forward to that too. We did it once before and we've expanded it a little bit and we've got some great feedback, so I'm looking forward to that. And then next month we will have our tech diva. She's always super popular. How now do I cloud? So she's going to give some information on Cloud Computing 101. That'll be next Thursday, October 12th. And I still remember when the cloud commercials first came out, and I'm like, what's the cloud? And now it's the most wonderful thing in the world. So, and then finally, also in October, we're having another, Renee and I will be at another Women's Career Conference in Pasadena. And that'll be super fun. That'll be really focused on career. And we're going to do a program there also on the essentials of investing also. And our final webinar of the year, we'll be hosting Dr. Lois Frankel. She's a New York Times best-selling author, a wonderful person, and she's going to be talking about what we need to do to get the corner office. So that's really trying to get us geared up for 2018 so we can just have the best year possible. So now I'm going to switch over to what we're doing today. And today, again, we are discussing investing in women, and we're going to have on today Kelly Coyne, who Kelly is our So I'll, Kelly's going to be speaking on investing in women. She is a vice president of advisor sales at Pax Ellevate Management. And that company is a joint venture between Pax World Investment Management and Sallie Krawcheck's firm of Ellevate Asset Management. Most importantly, Kelly is really interested in engaging and serving the next generation of clients, including millennials and, of course, women. And she's responsible for their project there, Millennials and Money and Women and Wealth. Of course, we've heard a lot about investing in women, and what Kelly's really going to talk about now is why this is not only a great idea for now, but a great idea for going forward. So I'm going to unmute Kelly, and then I'm going to let me hold on a second. Let me find her. There we go. And I'm going to switch the screen over to Kelly so she can get started. Kelly, can you talk to make sure I unmuted you?
Yes. Hi, Diane.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. And I think your screen is coming up now. Okay. I think we're good.
Okay. Great. Well, thanks so much. I'm very excited. Urban Wealth Management asked me to participate in this great speaker series. As Diane mentioned, my name is Kelly Coyne, and I work specifically on an initiative at Pax World, my firm, where the focus is on the advancement of women and gender equality. So before we dive into the meat of the presentation today, I'd like to share a short video. It's only 2 minutes. With everyone. We've recently put this video out and are very proud of it. It's already had over 1 million views. It's called Invest Like a Feminist. So let's hope technology agrees with us today. And here goes.
Hi, you guys. My phone tapped out. I don't know what happened.
Okay, are we back? Did that work?
You know what? It's a video. My phone tapped out. Hold on a second. Let me see. I think we missed the video. I'll send it out to everyone.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah, but we're back up. I'm sorry about that. It was fine. Somebody said it was fine, so I don't. I'll watch the recording before I send it out. Thank you. Thank you, Sarah.
Never
Thank
easy.
You, guys. They go right ahead.
Yeah. All right, great. So yeah, it's just a fun video. You could find it if you just type into Google. If anyone missed it, Pax Ellevate video. It's the first one that comes up. But yeah, I wanted to start with that because I think it was a great way to kick off what we're talking about today, investing in women. So let's begin and kind of back up a second. Hope everyone can see my slides fine. But this whole idea of trends, I want to give our minds a little test. So I hope everyone remembers when these images you see here were the new trends. They maybe seemed a little odd or even unlikely to take off, right? Organic foods, electric cars, tablets, smartphones, iPads, and so on. I'm a millennial, and even I can recall the first time I went into a Whole Foods and kind of chuckled, and now look, you know, almost every supermarket have aisles that look just like a Whole Foods market. You know, organic food is everywhere. Most major car manufacturers have electric car models. I actually read over the weekend that Tesla's newest model car, the Model 3, that was recently released, already has over 500,000 people on the wait list, and the number's growing by 1,800 a day. And, you know, I think that many of these brands and products are growing so rapidly in popularity with consumers because these are brands and products that are conscious of their role in society and their impact on the environment. Consumers today are different. You know, they want to align their purchasing dollars with brands that they can feel good about. And two examples that I want to point out that I don't actually have a picture of on the slide, but are Warby Parker and Tom's shoes. So these brands, you know, their success are simply based on the premise that the consumer can get the product that they're interested in buying, right? You know, but shoes or glasses in this example, but they have an immediate satisfaction of knowing that their purchase has a defined and tangible impact. You know, people in need somewhere in the world are now getting a pair of glasses or a pair of shoes because of them. So my point here is that, like I said, the world is changing. It's these kind of trends that we thought they were trends at the time are quickly becoming the new normal. And the consumer is evolving and realizing the power that they have with their money. Now, some people believe this woman thing, probably no one on this call, but they believe this woman thing is a trend, you know, trendy, hot topic of the moment. But that's really here to stay, too. So we're hearing women in leadership, pay equity, gender diversity. You know, these are all issues that have become a national or even a global conversation, and it's continuing to get even louder than it's been. So here on the slide, you'll see examples, right? The He for She campaign led by Emma Watson, the United States of Women effort from the White House, equal pay advocacy, you know, across many industries, but specifically we're seeing in tech and in Silicon Valley area take off. Sheryl Sandberg's Lean In book, that's really brought a lot of attention to this conversation. Also the Gina Davis Center for Gender in Media, which looks at women's roles or lack thereof in television and in film. But, you know, we say this woman thing at PAX, we say, you know, this isn't just a woman's thing, this is mainstream. It's continuing to be discussed. You know, another great example, not on the slide, but the marches that took place after the election. And this is a historic time, especially in our country, and we're at a tipping point. Now, sadly, some still say, you know, in 2017, women's equality is no longer an issue, right? Like, how could it be? But unfortunately, it is, and we can show you why over the next few slides. There's just a lot of more work to be done in building gender-balanced businesses and in advancing more women into leadership roles In fact, a recent survey that we have highlighted here from the Peterson Institute looked at over 22,000 companies, and it found that 60% of companies had no female board members, over half had no female C-suite executives, and 95% had no female CEO. The World Economic Forum, they've also forecasted that it will take 117 years before we reach gender parity in the workforce, which is jaw-dropping, I'm sure, to many of us, you know, in this day and age. There's some good news here too. You know, with this rising economic and financial power that women have, and you know, they're influencers, they're creating this wealth, they're controlling the wealth. Women are now on everyone's agenda. We control over $11 trillion. We're making more money than our spouse. You know, and the financial industry often, you know, arguably ignoring women as investors, are finally waking up to that. And women are too. You know, traditionally women are not investing as much as men. They're not working with financial advisors at the rate that men are. Those that are working with advisors are not always happy with them. So there's plenty of work to be done. But what we're seeing is this conversation of, you know, this women thing is really permeating into the financial services industry, and people are paying attention. What we have found in our research and just in our work with many women investors is that they're looking for different solutions. You know, ones that give them a fair return, but are also aligned with their values. There's a great study out from the Center for Talent Innovation, and in their global survey of high net worth women, they found that 90% of women say making an impact on society is important to them, and 77% of women say that they want to invest in companies with diversity and leadership. Another study that we looked at from U.S. Trust Annual Report found that 63% of women surveyed considered social, political, economic, or environmental impact when making their investment decisions. So these are just a few examples, but the research that we're looking at every day is very clear, and it points to very similar conclusions, which is that women want to have an impact with their money, and they also want to invest in other women. So why is that? And that is simply because women deliver results. At Pax, we have long believed that good things happen when women are in leadership roles, and there are countless research studies, we point to over 60, that are finding the same things. You know, when women are at the helm, at the table, in the boardroom, in senior management, companies often perform better. And we are seeing both the tangible and intangible, you know, sort of positive results that are exhibited when they have this diversity at the top. So we're talking about higher returns on invested capital, higher return on equity, lower risk. And then there's also the more intangibles, the greater client focus, the greater long-term focus, the stronger client relationships, all things that you want, you know, in a company that you're invested in. Here's an example pointing to just that from Credit Suisse. This is a chart that is showing companies with, or comparing companies with at least one woman on the board, with companies that have no women on their board over a five-year time period. And, you know, their results are showing that companies that have women on the board have greater performance. So you can see that will be the yellow line at the top. And there's plenty of other charts that look like this, especially not just looking at women on board, but women in senior management too. The performance is increased there, and the research is equally as compelling and clear that, again, these good things happen and that these companies actually perform better. So Diane mentioned Pax Ellevate and this joint venture we have with Sallie Krawcheck. And you know, simply put, we believe that investing in women is just a smart investment strategy, as highlighted in the last few slides. And that is why we created the first mutual fund that invests in the highest rated companies in the world when it comes to advancing women into leadership positions. So this fund is a joint venture between us, Pax World, and Sallie Krawcheck's business, Ellevate. And for those who aren't familiar with Sallie, here's a picture of her on the slide. But she's a rock star, total legend on Wall Street. She's headed up firms in the past, such as Smith Barney and Merrill Lynch. She was the CFO of Citi. Simply put, a very influential and impressive woman in the industry. So she came together with Pax because we share the same vision about the critical role that gender diversity plays in a business success over time, as well as the investment opportunity associated with investing in women. So long has Pax been a recognized leader in this space of investing in women and having a gender lens when looking at a company and a portfolio. We're also big advocates, especially on behalf of our shareholders, for increasing the number of women on boards, and a few other initiatives that I'll hit now, kind of on the next slide. This is a big part of what we do, proxy voting, engaging with companies on key issues, and then investing, you know, finally in those companies. So to step back for those unfamiliar with sort of the shareholder advocacy note, we think investors can make a serious impact and be part of the solution when it comes to these key issues, so closing the gender gap and advancing women into senior roles, so boards, management, C-suite, et cetera. And we engage with the companies we own on these issues, and we try to help them build a better gender-balanced business. So how do we do that? We vote our proxies against all male board slates of directors. We then write letters to those companies that we vote no against, explaining why we voted no and offering guidance as to how to increase board diversity, and also the business case of why this makes sense. So let's say they don't necessarily care just to be, you know, right and include women and diversity at the top. If that's the case, well, then here's a business case. Here's why your company will actually perform better, and maybe that will, you know, be the trigger for them. And then we also engage companies on issues such as pay equity. That's a big one that we focused on last year. So we engaged with a handful of tech companies and financial firms, mostly because they're notoriously bad in this arena. So, for example, we engaged with Apple, Amazon, and eBay, all who responded to us. We engaged in a productive dialogue, and ultimately they fulfilled our request to show transparency. They conducted internal audits, and they ended up disclosing the results of those audits for everyone to see their gender pay ratio. So for these three massive companies to sort of lead the way in doing this, you know, working with a firm like Pax along the way to disclose something that they're not necessarily required to is having that impact. So often we get asked by our shareholders, you know, what is the impact I'm making? You know, that this is a tangible example that they can point to and say, because I, you know, am invested this way, you know, this is the result of what happened. And there's other great success stories with companies adding women to their board, just like with these companies deciding to disclose their pay equity ratio. So that's some big wins for us and other companies like Pax fighting alongside us in this fight. So we believe, you know, kind of to wrap things up here, and I'm very happy to take any questions on any of this, but that the case for investing in women is very clear and hopefully compelling to everyone. You know, investing in companies that invest in women is simply just smart business. You know, making a positive difference for women in the workplace is the nice thing to do, but also it's the smart thing to do, and that's what we try to get across, and that's why we launched the Pax Ellevate Fund, as I mentioned. It's also why we advocate strongly on behalf of our shareholders, and it's why we work with great firms like Urban Wealth Management, who we like to say get it. many of their clients are interested in aligning their investments with their values. And I'm sure if anyone on the line is, this is a value of theirs that they're interested in, Diane can help kind of connect the dots. We are just one product that is out there. Since we launched the Pax Ellevate Women's Fund, there has been a handful of other companies that have launched funds with similar investment thesis. And that is, makes us happy. That's pleasing to us because that's just showing this is such a strong investment thesis and in a way to add, hopefully, alpha to a portfolio. But it's just something that, to us, makes sense. You know, the quality of a management team, we're defining a strong quality there as greater gender diversity. And, I'm happy to take any questions. Diane, if I've left anything out, please let me know. And thank you, everyone, for your time.
Yes, thank you so much, Kelly. If you have some questions, just drop them in the chat box real quick. We have a few more minutes. Kelly did mention, adding alpha. For those not in the business, that just means increasing your performance as compared to a benchmark. But maybe, Kelly, you could talk about really quickly, people sometimes say, oh, I have my investment strategy, or, most of my money's already tied up in my 401k or my IRA, it's not really practical to switch, and do something different. And Renee and I also often talk about how this could be just one portion of your overall investment strategy and portfolio. So maybe you could talk about some of those practices and what you've seen, how advisors work with their clients in incorporating this into an ongoing investment strategy.
Sure. And we see people do very different, have very different approaches to this. So for those, to back up a little, those that aren't familiar with Pax World, we have 12 mutual funds, and they are all have some kind of an impact or a sustainable investing tilt. So we do work with many clients that are interested in having a complete sustainable investment portfolio or an impact portfolio. So that would be on one hand, where this fund is a global large cap equity fund. It could fit right in there. But then we also have those that use this fund in their retirement accounts for sure. They sort of dabble with starting to see the impact and start out small. The minimum is only $1,000 to invest in the fund. We often see, like I said, women, the next gen, millennials, their kids kind of gearing more towards impact investing. So starting out, introducing it in maybe your kids' accounts is another idea. But this is a fund, it might seem a little out there, but it's not. If you looked at the list of the 400 companies we own in this fund, you would be, you would not look at it and say, whoa, this is a woman's fund. You know, it's Amazon, it's Microsoft, it's Xerox, it's, big, large names that you probably own in other funds in your portfolio as is. This is just our way of identifying a specific group of these large cap, really well-known, high-quality names. So it's not as difficult to work into a portfolio as some people might think.
Cool. And then there's a question that asks, what do we know about why adding one woman to a board or a couple of women in the C-suite, do we have any data about why that can change the change a company and make it more productive and resourceful?
So yes, and we short answer yes. We have a ton of this research. If you're interested, on our Pax World website, it's very easy to find. Also, if you're interested to really dive in, but what the research is saying is gender diverse teams perform better than non-gender diverse teams. So it'll look at, and you could think about it simply as groupthink. Sallie talks a lot, Sallie Krawcheck talks a lot about this, that if you have, five point guards on the basketball, the best five point guards in the world playing on the same team, you know, that's not actually going to win. That team isn't actually going to win the game because they're all the same. They all have the same skills. And you can equate that to a boardroom of typically the white middle-aged male, Ivy League educated, very smart. Maybe they're, you know, all majored in econ or, you know, finance, and they don't have the diversity of thought that actually delivers better decision making. So gender diversity is what is where the most research is around, but it's really diversity of all kinds that they're showing lead to these better, higher quality decisions being made out of the top leadership teams. And that's why we point to the board and the senior management and the C-suite levels. So there's specific research on each group. And like I said, I can point anyone in that direction, but what it's saying is that groupthink is not how you come up with the best decisions at these companies. Well, you kind of run into the same problem.
Right. We'll share the research with the when we send out the recording. And just a final thought, and maybe real quick, because it's a little we should tie up right now. Is there an SRI screen, a social responsive screen, which is another screen that can include women, right, when you talk about mm-hmm. board governance. Is there a social responsive screen on Pax Ellevate? Because one of the participants indicated there it may be as fossil fuel free. Is that correct?
This fund is not fossil fuel free. However, we do have funds that are. That's of interest. This fund does have a ESG or sustainable initial screen where we eliminate the laggards, so kind of the worst offenders when it comes to those issues.
Environmental bad people.
Exactly. So we look at 1,600 companies and essentially roughly about 200 are taken out because of that screen. So it's really designed to really just look at finding the best companies in the world when it comes to women at the top. So we don't want to deviate too much from that and put in too many other factors. But we do eliminate the worst companies when it comes to that because those just aren't companies you want to own anyway.
Got it. Okay, perfect. Thank you. A lot of dialogue.
Yeah, sure.
A lot of folks online. Thank you, everyone. We'll send out the recording. Don't forget, like maybe in the middle, there's a break on the video. So just, you know, forward on. We'll look at the recording before we send it out, and if there's any messages in terms of how to navigate it, we will make sure April includes that in the recording. I will also send out a link to Pax Ellevate's research. There's another company, Trillium, that does a lot of research in this area also. And and then I'll share Sallie Krawcheck's website also. She's just, and to follow her on LinkedIn. She always has really great ideas for women in the financial space. A lot of the data says that we don't feel as confident as men do, and I think looking at some of this information and watching Sally Small Bullets joining our Facebook group, Smart Women Savvy Money. So if you haven't done that, please go on Facebook and make a request to join that. There's always, we try to keep things short, and Sally tries to keep things short. We try to provide articles. I write some articles. Renee does too. So our goal is that as women, we can be the smartest investors possible so that we can achieve our dreams, whatever they happen to be for us. Okay, so thank you all. Have a great day. I appreciate you staying online. Take it easy, and thank you, Kelly, so much.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.